Oh, hi. My name is Ziggy, and you probably haven't heard of me because I spent most of my time tucked away in a natural history museum. Now, you probably haven't heard of the disease called schistosomiasis either. It's a neglected tropical disease that infects over 250 million people worldwide and kills about 200,000 each year. And the organism that is responsible for that is called a schisto, and it's a tiny worm. You probably won't even be able to see it. But we've actually got a better picture somewhere else in the museum. What I should probably add here is that the species of the schistosome that you are about to see is not a species that can infect humans, but it looks very, very similar. But back to the lab for now. So usually what I do in my PhD is I study the ways how to detect schistosomiasis in the environment. Now that's usually done by collecting snails, which are the intermediate hosts of this parasite, and looking for emerging larvae called Sicarii. I can actually show you some right here. Now each of those larvae is about 0.25 millimeters long, but it only takes two of those to infect a human being. But today, I'd like to show you something slightly different, and for that, we're gonna need fish. It. It's not an actual fish, it's just a paper one, but have a look under the microscope. Now the fish you see here are juvenile Oreochrom sneloticus, also known as Nile tilapia. However, they can grow as big as 45 centimeters. And the really interesting thing about them is that they have almost perfect overlap with distribution of schistosomes in Africa. Now, what I'm really interested in about these fish is whether there's a way we could use it to detect transmission of schistosomiasis in the field. How, you ask? Using its poop? That's a bit weird. But there are actually some papers saying that young Oreochromis eats the larvae of schistosomes. I'm going to show this to you upstairs. Now previously this hasn't been tested using molecular biology, but instead just counting the Sicarii that remained in tanks after experiments. So now when I've mentioned that this has been tested before, just to show you that I wasn't kidding, there's some papers about this, but you won't read them anyway, will you? Actually, I might. Anyway, so to further test this using PCR methods, I decided to do a microcosm experiment. Now what I did is I filled a big tank with 25 liters of water, added some food that would serve as alternative prey to my fish, so some weeds, some duckweed, some bloodworms, some non-infected snails. I added a snail that was shedding schistosome Sicarii, and then I added 15 juvenile Oreochromis neloticus that you've met before. And then what I did is I left the system untouched for 24 hours. And in the morning, when I came back, I immediately noticed that the alternative prey has been consumed, but I wanted to see if the fish have been eating Sicarii too. So this is when the time was to collect the fish poop as well. To do this, I set up a separate aquarium into which I placed the fish in groups of five and left them there overnight to be able to collect their feces. And then, sure enough, when I came back in the morning, I found some fish poop in the tank. So what I did, I collected all the feces in a tube. And then, full of excitement, I ran to the lab. Now to see whether there's the parasite DNA in the fish poop, I have developed my PCR primers specifically for that. But first, I had to extract the DNA. This is a bit simplified, by the way. Now after extraction, I took out a bit of the DNA sample, and then what I did is I subjected it to the PCR. Now the PCR usually takes a bit longer than this, but
I had to speed it up a little. What you can see now, and usually this is a bit more complicated than this, but there definitely was some DNA amplified in there, as you can see from my expertly created DIY DNA molecule. I then sequenced the product and confirmed that this was indeed the schistosome DNA. Now what this means is that I have successfully shown that I can detect the DNA of the parasite in the feces of a fish who ate its larvae. What this means is that we could potentially use the fish to monitor the transmission of the disease. It also indicates that the fish might have an effect on the transmission of the disease by controlling the populations of the parasite. Oh, and one more fun fact. Did you know that Trematodes Carey is a rock star in Nirvana's video clip in Come As You Are?